Hello, my name is Cheryl Balfed and I work at CPUT. I've been working here for about 7 years, and for the last 2 and a bit years I've been working with Daniela Gacago and with Bronwyn Swartz.
I think Toronto really provided an ideal framework. Just the perspectives, the research lenses, later when we reflected, of course, I don't know if we're allowed to admit, but we didn't think about it using Toronto when we went ahead and we did it. But as we reflected on it afterwards, Toronto actually allowed us that space to unpack it and really critically review it, because there was good and there was bad.
Yes.
It helped us to see the shortfalls and make us better practitioners. Mm. But it also helped us to see where the strengths were and what we can use, harness,
and how we can. It's a double-edged sword. You must be very appropriate at all times. You've got to think before you act.
Absolutely.
Mm. How are you caring? Because you can so easily overstep the line and then not achieve the outcome. Mm. And it's very important to achieve that.
Absolutely, I agree with you.
That for me was the biggest learning curve. Mm. Because I see it in the everyday practice that I carry out.
Because you have a huge impact and you don't realize it at the time. At the time you're focused on your goal. Mm. And later you think, oh my God.
And I like to get it right the first time if I can choose to get it right the first time. If I have a choice in the matter, I want to get it right the first time. I don't want to...
But I don't think we've ever gotten it right the first time, because we're always improving.
It's probably in the conversation. I don't worry too much anymore. I trust myself. And I think that's the biggest thing, is I trust myself.
And your students.
And my students. They invigorate me because they respond. Mm. They always respond. This is the thing. And I find now they keep me on my toes. Oh boy.
I personally don't think that you can prepare for everything. I think more than anything else, it's just having that confidence. I resonate with that. It's just having that confidence in your ability. And not even having confidence, not being scared. Mm. That's what I think. Just not being scared. Just deciding that there's something more important than your own ego.
Absolutely.
Because you're putting yourself out there. You're making yourself vulnerable. Mm. But you're doing it for a purpose.
Absolutely.
And I think that's why we do what we did, what we did. And your students become part of your team. You and your students become a team.
A team, absolutely.
Yeah.
And if there's any errors anywhere, they will find it.
And they're going to help you.
And they're going to help you make it better. Mm. So that reflection, that iterative process, it is the biggest learning curve there is. Mm. So
for me, I felt there was a bigger distance between myself and my students. And when Fierce Missile happened, we joined the same team. Mm-hmm. We were on the same team, playing for the same team.
But you also learn a little bit of, there's a discipline that comes with an experience like that. For example, depending on the tool that you're using, office hours can become 24 hours a day, and of course that is not sustainable. So one finds you go forward and then you have to take a step back and recognize, I'm sending the wrong message. I need to be more appropriate to this, because long term I may ultimately pay the price for it, and there's many
ways. Are you going to?
So you sort of pull yourself back a bit, and the ethic of key, appropriate key, you know, because ultimately you could be doing the wrong thing, although it seems to serve the interim, it might not serve the long-term need, you know. That's significant, I think, because we can end up getting too much of ourselves, and we have to have a limit, you know, so we can stay in this business and not burn out.
Unless, of course, you realize the student's melting down, and then... Because we're people.
We are people, yeah.
Thank you.